Hey, welcome to another episode of GeekOutdoors.com. And just the other day, Samsung officially announced the Samsung Galaxy Note 7. Now, they didn't go with the 6, they went straight to 7. And my first thoughts and impressions are that it's kind of boring, you know? Now, before I get into what I mean by boring, let's quickly go over the specs, okay? Now, the Samsung Galaxy Note 7 has a 5.7-inch Quad HD Super AMOLED panel. And then under the hood, it actually has a Snapdragon 820 processor with 4 gigs of RAM, 64 gigs of storage with micro SD card expansion, and of course, no Note would be complete without the S Pen. Now, some notable new features are, first and foremost, it actually has a USB Type-C connection, so no more micro USB, and also, the screen itself, it actually has this new feature that is HDR always, meaning whenever you're watching video, Samsung will use technology to upscale it to HDR. So that should definitely improve the viewing experience, even though it already had an amazing screen. Some other features are that it also has a brand new iris scanner. Now, you know, face recognition has been on Android for a while, even with the eye tracking, but this iris scanner is actually a separate camera or module that will actually track your eyes that they can use for security purposes where you can unlock your phone, which is pretty cool. Okay, now let's get to the part where it's boring to me, okay? And what I mean by that is, no doubt about it, this is a premium design. I'm loving this design. You know, I really like the way that Samsung is heading with the premium features and finish that we would come to expect from a flagship phone. However, it's not just the Note 7. You know, phones nowadays, they're all kind of the same. You know, it's like kind of like the iPhone. You know, you kind of know what to expect. And now that smartphones are so prevalent, you know, they're commodities, I just don't really get super excited about phones anymore. You know, and that's really not the fault of the manufacturers. It's just that we're kind of used to them now. They're all square. I mean, under the hood, there's just more specs. And, you know, besides the HD screens, more RAM and so forth, they're pretty much just the same. You know, they're square. Yeah, so I don't get excited really about the new phones that are coming out. You know, I was definitely excited when I got my LG G5, not because it was anything novel, because, you know, I just had an old phone and I was finally getting a new one, okay? Now, I'm really not going to get too excited about too many smarts in the future until they do something really new and something amazing. So, you know, something like the new flexible panels, you know, whenever that comes out, you know, either to Samsung, LG, Sony, who knows? I can't wait till those phones come out where they're so thin and you could actually, like, wrap them around your arm or something, you know, that type of technology. Or maybe holographic screens, you know, like really taking augmented reality to the next level where it'd just display virtual keyboards or something like that. You know, that would be cool. So, but at this point, you know, I'm not really excited about any of the upcoming smartphones. And although that really, you know, takes nothing away from the quality that the Samsung's putting out with their Note series and their S series, I just really don't see anything to get excited about. And as a matter of fact, when I first saw it, it really looked just like a Samsung Galaxy S6 Edge Plus with the S Pen. So, you know, what are your thoughts about this? You know, I mean, did the Note 7 impress you? Were there any features that you like? Or was it just meh? So, leave your comments and ideas below. And as always, I am on Snapchat at Geek Outdoors. Thanks for watching.
Thanks for checking out this episode. And as always, if you like these videos, be sure to click on the subscribe button. And for full written content, audio content, and additional geek stuff, head over to geekoutdoors.com, and I'll see you outdoors on the very next episode.